Welcome students. Students, we have studied the first stanza of the poem Bhilesham, and we studied how the girl is fed up with the worldly life and she is determined to go to the wild forest. But her mother is trying her best to persuade her daughter not to go to the forest. The mother asks her daughter some questions. Let us study the second stanza of the poem Bhilesham to know the reply of the girl. Let us see the second stanza. The second stanza is like this. Mother mine, to the white forest I am going, where upon the champa boughs the champa birds are blowing, to the quail haunted river isles, where lotus lilies glisten, the voices of the fairy folk are calling me. Oh, listen. Once again. Mother mine, to the wild forest I am going, where upon the champa birds are blowing, to the quail haunted river isles, where lotus lilies glisten, the voices of the fairy folk are calling me. Oh, listen. This is the second stanza. Let us see the words, unfamiliar words and phrases. The first word is boughs. Boughs means branches. Branches, boughs. Champa, name of a flower, also named as champak, also known as champak. Champa, name of a flower. So champa bird, you can see champa bird. This is a champa bird. Here, this is the picture of a champa bird. चंपा बर्ड चंपा कढ़ी जोटा कहती चंपा बर्ड. नेक्स्ट वर्ड इज रिवर आइल्स. एज यू नो आइल आइल इज द पोएटिक फॉर्म ऑफ आइलैंड. आइल होची आइलैंड रो होची पद्य रूप को हमें आइल कहती. रिवर आइल्स, ए स्मॉल आइलैंड इन द रिवर. सी द पिक्चर, दिस इज ए रिवर आइल. नदी पठा जोटा को हमें उड़िया रे कहती. दिस इज ए रिवर आइल. ए स्मॉल पीस ऑफ लैंड इन द मिडिल ऑफ द रिवर इज कॉल्ड रिवर आइल्स. आइल इज द poetic form of the word island. Another phrase, quail hunted river isles. Quail is a singing bird, you know. We have already learned about quail in the poem The Solitary Reaper. Quail is a singing bird. Quail hunted river isles. The river isles which are frequently visited by quail bird. Jo nadi pathaku barambar koili mane janti. Sei nadi pathaku ame kahuchanti quail hunted river isles. Mane the river isles is echoed with the sweet music of the quail. That is called quail haunted river isles. Next word, lotus. Lotus is the name of a flower. You can see the picture. This is the picture of a lotus. Lily. Lily, name of a flower. There are different types of lily. This is a type of lily. This is also a type of lily flowers. Different types of lily. This lily generally grows in water. This type of lilies grow in land, on land. So there are different types of lily. Lily is also a flower. Glisten. Glisten means shine, chak chakariya, bright, become brightened. Fairy. Small supernatural creatures having magical powers. So I mean, have apsara boli kahanti, pari boli kahanti, that is called fairy. Fairy folk means a group of fairies. Fairies. Pari manakar dala ko ame thi fairy folk boli ko hauchi, that is called fairy folk. These are the words. Let us see the summary. As you know, we have studied in the first stanza of the poem, the mother asks her daughter where she is going. In reply to her mother's questions, the girl is replying, the girl is answering, mother mine, I am going to the wild forest. The girl says that she is going to the wild forest. Why does she want to go to the wild forest? To enjoy the beauty of nature. To live in the lap of nature, prakruti kolare jivan bitai dabo. The girl is quite fed up with the worldly life. Her urges to go to the wild forest is stronger than the ties at home. Sansararo bandhana tharu taro jo buli mane prakruti kolaku jibar ichha ta adhika shaktishali hei parchi. Her urges to go to the wild forest is stronger than the ties at home. So she wants to leave her mother, leaves her home. To enjoy the beauty of nature. She says that the champa flowers on champa branches. What does he see in the forest? Champa flowers on champa branches. Quail hunted river isles and the bright and lotus lily. The girl will see these things in the wild forest. And the girl says that these things, these champa flowers, the quail hunted river isles and bright lotus and lily attract her very, very much. The girl becomes irresistible, uncontrollable. She also listens to the voices of fairy folk who are calling her to the lap of nature. Nature, the girl realizes that the fairy folk are calling her. When she, the girl is very much attracted by the fairy folk and by the beauty of the nature. So she wants to go to the lap of nature. So this is the summary of the second stanza. Let us see questions. Where is the girl going? The girl is going to the wild forest. To the wild forest. Why does the girl want to go to the wild forest? Why? To enjoy the beauty of nature. To live in the lap of nature. So the girl wants to go to the wild forest. Next question. Where are the champa buds blowing? Champa buds are blowing upon the champa boughs, upon the champa branches, on the champa branches. The champa buds are blowing. Next question. What do you mean by quail hunted river isles? I have already said you. What do you mean? What is the meaning of quail hunted? Quail hunted river isles means the river isles which are frequently visited by quail. The river isles, as I have said you, isles is the isle is the poetic form of island. Island. So dipara padyaru pohuchi isles. Isles. Jimti ame bheli ra bhel island ra isles. The river isles, quail hunted river isles means the river isles which are frequently visited by quail. Jo river isle ko quail mane barambara jaanti. Jo quail, jo river isles which is echoed with the sweet voice of the quail is called quail hunted river isles. Next question. Which flowers have been mentioned in the poem? Which flowers? Champa, lotus and lily. These three flowers have been mentioned in the poem. Next question. Where do lotus and lily glisten? Glisten means shine. On the river isles. On the river isles, lotus and lily glisten. Next. Whose voices are calling the girl? Whose voices? Who are calling means here, the voices are not calling. Man, the girl is attracted. The whose voices are attracting the girl? The voices of the fairy folk. The voices of the fairy folk are calling the girl. What makes the girl irresistible? Irresistible means uncontrollable. अथय कर देइछि जोंटा हम अथय बोली कहंती उड़िया रे को जिंस झेटा को अथय कर देइछि हला. The girl becomes irresistible to go to the wild forest. What makes her irresistible? Irresistible, its negative prefix बसछि ir, irresistible. The beauty of nature and the voices of the fairy folk makes the girl irresistible. So students, this is all about the second stanza of the poem The Village Song. Students, this is for today.